The blade of the dagger just fitted between the door and the soft wood frame. The door gave slightly, and then held firm. My fingers were too big to reach into the tiny crack. There was nothing very useful in my bag, just a single hair clip. The tray was empty. The hair clip into the slot and whatever was stuck there disappeared into the machine. The tray was empty. I pulled out an old English penny. The penny was too large to fit into the slot. I put the old penny into the slot, the needle twitched rustily, and the machine spat out a card. Non. The machine looked like it had sold its last ticket a long time ago. I remembered my student days when I regularly forgot my house keys. A wiggle with the thick card between the frame and the lock, and the latch lifted. The train was my ride out of here. I could worry about not having a ticket when I got to the docks.
Nothing. I mean... As soon as I stooped to investigate the hole, its inhabitant disappeared into the darkness. The creature disappeared again, but I caught a glimpse of something small and furry. If I jumped, I could just about reach the branch. Climbing the tree was... Oh no, I wasn't going in there. end of the reed had been neatly bitten off. Now I knew what was living in there. A long-toothed, snarling, furry wild thing. It was home to something with more teeth than kind thoughts in its head. The dart fitted snugly into the reed. Great. I was tooled up and dangerous. Climbing the tree wasn't going to help any in this situation. Just came away from the rock as I pulled it. The creeper didn't look like it would hold my weight. The creeper felt unpleasant and fleshy. The creeper felt you It was the electronic marker which Bronson used with his theodolite. The marker clipped firmly onto Great. I'd created some sort of creeper marker fishing net assembly. Sometimes I terrify myself with my creative genius. I'd successfully got the marker into a position near the top of the needle simply by using the kind of lateral thinking that can get you institutionalized. No good. I'd have to be bitten by a radioactive spider before I stood any chance of getting up there. Climbing the tree wasn't going to help any in this situation. It was Bronson's theodolite. Stay cool, Stobart. It was only a bird. Hold on. I've been here before, haven't I? The hill I was on had reminded me of a camel's hump as I'd climbed up it. Now I had to see what I could see. Joining the dots would make an equilateral triangle.